Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 44. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review, Problem 44. We have 5x times in parentheses 3x squared minus x, and then minus 3x squared times in parentheses 4 minus 5x. And we want to see what that'll simplify to. So what I'm going to do is start by multiplying whatever's outside of the parentheses times each item inside the parentheses. So for the first set of parentheses, it'll start with 5x times 3x squared. So first I'll just focus on the 5 times 3, and that'll be a 15. Then I will consider the x times x to the second. That's going to give me an x to the third. Again, the 5x in front of the parentheses, it doesn't really have an exponent, but you can assume it's an x to the first. So I added 1 plus 2 more for a third power. So now 5x times negative x will be minus 5x squared. So again, I focus first on the numbers. This doesn't have a number in front. You can assume it's a minus 1x at the second part of the parentheses. So 5 times minus 1, there's my minus 5. The next times x, x to the second. Next, I'll look at 3x squared times 4 minus 5x in parentheses. So the 3x squared times the 4 will be minus 12x squared. Again, pay attention to the sign. It's really a minus 3x squared in front of the parentheses. And finally, minus 3x squared times minus 5x to the first. So focus on just the numbers initially. So negative 3 times negative 5 will be positive 15. And now the x is x squared times an x to the first will be x to the third. So I got a 15x to the third. Now that I've cleared my parentheses, let me combine whatever can be combined. So in order to combine different x's, it's not just the variable that has to match, but the exponent also. So the 15x to the third and another 15x to the third will give me 15 and 15 is 30x to the third. So the 15x to the third in the beginning and the 15x to the third at the end are accounted for. I'll just cross them out. Now, the x squares can be combined also. I have negative 5x squared and negative 12x squared. So negative 5 and negative 12 is negative 17x squared. So I get an answer of 30x to the third minus 17x to the second. And as I look at my list of possible options, I do have a perfect match at option B. So the answer for this problem is B.